Welcome to the 13th lecture. So, we will continue with the previous lecture, whatever we have been discussing. We need to prove this. So, for proving this, we can write this is equivalent to, this we can write as A tilde, see here, this is the inner product, this is a vector, this is a vector. And so, this vector and this vector, and here this is, there is a transpose, so that makes it a inner product. So, we can write this as A tilde dot times A tilde cross times A tilde dot. This can be rewritten, this can be written as A tilde cross A tilde dot. We take this dot product from here to here. So, there will be exchange of this dot will become cross and this cross will become dot. Now, if we use this, so this part is now obviously 0. So, 0 times A tilde dot, this will be equal to 0. So, what we see that this quantity is 0, and therefore, the previous expression we have been working with, this gets reduced to phi dot. So, already we have written from the geometry that this would be equal to phi dot, which indeed turns out to be equal to phi dot. So, we need a number of identities to prove few things, and those identities are like last time we have discussed, this is equal to 1. So, this implies A tilde times transpose times A tilde dot equal to A tilde dot transpose times A tilde, this equal to 0, and then A tilde cross A tilde, obviously this quantity will be 0, and this will imply A tilde dot cross A tilde equal to minus A tilde cross A tilde dot. If we differentiate it, so the two terms will be differentiated, take right hand side is 0, taking on the right hand side we get this quantity. And then we have another identity, A tilde dot cross times A tilde cross, this usually we write as A tilde dot, the cross is written up because this indicates a matrix. Similarly, here this part indicates a matrix. So, this is A tilde cross. So, this part will be equal to A tilde times A tilde dot transpose, and this can be proved. Similarly, we have A tilde times A tilde dot transpose times A tilde cross. This can be proved. And lastly, we have A tilde dot times A tilde transpose minus and all of them can be proved. It will be better that we do this as part of the tutorial, otherwise I feel can we cover it today. Let me try. We will pick up this A tilde dot cross times A tilde cross. This we need to prove that A tilde times A tilde dot transpose. So, for working this, what the trick we can apply, that just write this as, let us assume that this is operating on a vector nu. The left hand side we are taking, and we have to prove that this is equal to the right hand side. So, what it indicates that this quantity equal to, this is A tilde from here this is A tilde cross nu, or either if you want to write it in the form of vector. So, equally you can write in terms of vector, it is not a problem. So, that means that we can write this as A dot cross A cross B cross, and then if we break it up, A dot V times A minus A dot A. We write it in this way. This quantity, we know that this quantity is 0, A dot A already we have, because this is the A dot A, this is nothing but A tilde dot transpose times A tilde which we have already written as 0. Okay, now we have to look into this quantity. So, this we can write as A times A dot nu, this is operating on nu vector. Now, remove from both sides this nu. So, this is A dot cross times A cross, this will be equal to A dot, and this quantity is nothing but your A transpose A, or in terms of if you write it is A tilde transpose times A tilde, and here we have dropped out this part. So, we okay, this part is here, this A remains here in this place. So, this is A times A dot, and here this is the dot. So, A transpose. So, this quantity equal to A tilde transpose times A tilde dot. So, you can see that dot was here on the front one, the first one. So, it has gone to the second one. Here there was no dot. So, dot is here. Okay. So, this way we have proved that A tilde dot cross A tilde cross, this will be equal to A tilde transpose times A tilde dot. So, if we use this technique, so we will be able to prove many such identities. So, next we have the next identity, we have A tilde dot times A tilde transpose minus actually these identities are required while we deal with getting the reverse thing, means if we are looking to get A dot and phi dot from omega, so at that time these things will be required. So, the next we need to prove this quantity. And the way of doing is the same as we have done earlier, but here this particular expression it is an expansion of a certain term that we need to write first. Just ek minute ke liye yahan pe pause karunga, mera paper dhoondna hai. ओके, तो हम स्टार्ट कर सकते हैं फिर।
हाँ सर, चल रहा है।
अच्छा, नाउ व्हाट वी लुक इनटू, दिस इज द आइडेंटिटी वी यूज। सो इफ यू लुक इनटू दिस पार्टिकुलर पार्ट, सो दिस इज नथिंग बट इफ यू लुक इन द वेक्टर नोटेशन, दिस इज नथिंग बट ए वन टाइम्स ए टू क्रॉस, इट्स समथिंग लाइक दिस। से if you are operating on vector v, okay, so the right hand side is like this, and on the left hand side the same thing will appear as a1 cross a2 cross v minus a2 cross a1 cross v. So this is an identity which is part of vector triple product. Okay, so we use this identity here to solve for this. So if you look into this, if we replace a1 cross by already previously what we have done, that see here this is a1 tilde cross and a2 tilde cross. Okay, so we will replace this a2 tilde cross here by a tilde dot and a1 tilde cross by a tilde. So if we replace in this equation and then we see that what the result comes. So here using this identity we can replace this by a1 by a tilde. So this is a tilde cross times a tilde dot cross minus a tilde dot cross times a tilde cross, and on the right hand side then we will have a tilde cross. And this part then we have a2 is nothing but a tilde dot and then whole cross. So if we go back and look into this, a tilde cross times a tilde, this is turning out to be this. On the other hand, if the same quantity is, if you write it like this, the things will get reversed and you will have a tilde dot, it will appear like this. Again here we have done the mistake, we need to correct it. This is a times, we have already done this part, so here this is transpose, here this is dot. Okay, so this is a times, so this is the outer product, outer product. Again here also we need to correct it. So this is our outer product. Okay, so if we utilize this result, so we can utilize it here. So this will get reduced to a tilde dot times a tilde transpose minus a tilde transpose times a tilde dot. Okay, this dot will turn up again, this is transpose, this will be equal to a tilde cross times a tilde dot cross. So now go back and what here in this place, this is what we were looking for, a tilde dot a tilde transpose a tilde times a tilde dot. Okay, on the right hand side we have this. Okay. So this is the identity which we have proved using the vector triple product properties. So this is another identity from the vector triple product which we have just picked up and put here in this format. Okay. Okay, so lastly we have proved that a tilde times a tilde dot transpose a tilde this is the last identity that we need to prove. Okay, so we start in the same way that we take the left hand side first and multiply it on both sides by we multiply this by nu. So, we can write this as A tilde times A tilde transpose and this operates on this vector nu equal to minus A tilde dot cross nu, and later on again we will take out nu from both the sides and see the right hand side equality is satisfied or not. So, we will remove this part. Let us think that this is the left hand side, we are operating on nu, the vector nu, and then rewrite this quantity. So, this quantity is nothing but A tilde dot cross using the previous one we have derived, A tilde cross times A tilde cross, and this will operate on A tilde cross. So, this is say it is something like this, and this is going to operate on this nu, and plus the same way here A tilde cross and A tilde dot. So, this is A tilde cross times A tilde dot cross, and this will be operating on this vector. And then break this. If we break it, A tilde this is A tilde dot nu times A tilde minus A tilde transpose. Okay, we have done. Okay, this is fine. We have converted this, so this is okay. Now, this is A dot A, and this is our nu, and plus A tilde cross. A tilde dot nu times A tilde dot minus nu, and then obviously it has to be operated by this cross product. So, what we get from here, this is a scalar quantity. So, therefore, we can write as A tilde cross A tilde times A tilde dot nu minus A tilde, this is your A tilde, so this quantity is 1. So, here what we get, just nu plus. Now, one more thing here we are missing. While we break the bracket, so it will operate on this one. So, this will be A tilde cross nu times A tilde, this is 1. So, A tilde dot cross nu, this and this. Okay. Plus, again we have to break here in this place. So, A tilde cross A tilde dot this and this we have taken here in this place. This quantity is the nothing but A tilde transpose times A tilde dot. So, this quantity is 0, already we have observed it. Okay, so this part gets reduced to 0 and this is what we have here. Okay, these are the three parts we are having. So, overall we have, now you look into this part, this is both same, these two are same, and here the dot comes afterwards, your dot comes in front. So, this is nothing but minus a tilde cross a tilde dot, this quantity. So, this and this they cancel out, and what we get here minus a tilde dot cross. So, this we can write as minus a tilde dot cross. Now, remove from here, we operated on this vector v. So, if we remove it, so this is what we get. So, from here this equal to, ultimately we can write here this equal to minus a tilde dot cross v. Okay. So, you can see that we can remove this v and this is what the result we were looking for. So, this is proved. So, I will remove it finally, not to confuse that we are putting in the beginning. So, therefore, this implies a tilde times a tilde dot transpose a tilde cross plus this equal to minus a tilde dot cross. So, these are some of the results which are very useful while reducing the matrices. Okay, already we have observed that omega tilde, this is nothing but phi dot times a tilde minus 1 minus cos phi tilde cross times a tilde dot plus sin phi times a tilde dot. Okay. So, from here then we can get this phi dot and a tilde dot also. So, for this what we need to do, that operate on both sides a tilde cross omega. Okay, on both sides we just operate by this a tilde cross. So, if we do that, this quantity will be equal to 0, 1 minus cos phi times a tilde cross a tilde cross a tilde dot, this is the quantity here, and plus sin phi times a tilde cross times a tilde dot. So, obviously, this quantity here vanishes. This implies one minus cos phi remember we can either write like this or either we can write like this. Okay. If we write it like this, this indicates that this is a matrix, a skew symmetric matrix, this is a skew symmetric matrix and this is operating on this vector, and if you are writing here in this format, so we are just working with the vector notation and we can do the vector operation here. So, this is the difference. If I write it up, so that indicates that this is a matrix. If I write it in this way, this indicates vector. So, here I have, and either way if you proceed, result will be the same because they are the same thing. Like if I have omega cross r, okay, so this is the vector product, and the same thing I can write as omega tilde cross r. Means here we are dealing with a skew symmetric matrix, and then here we are writing r 1 r 2 r 3, or either write here in this format omega 1 say e 1 cap plus omega 2 e 2 cap plus omega 3 e 3 cap, and then cross product with r 1 times e 1 cap plus r 2 times e 2 cap plus r 3 times e 3 cap. If you do this, you will get a vector. Here also you will get a vector, but here you get a, they are in the matrix format, and here in the original vector format, but the results of both of them will be identical, that will nothing be different. Okay. So, it does not make difference whether we write it like this or either we write it like this. Okay, so, this part, and then we have sin phi a tilde cross a tilde dot, and we need to expand it further so that it gets reduced into a simplified format. This part we can expand. Now, here if you look into this, this is in the vector triple form product format. So, we can write this as, okay, this is a tilde times a tilde dot, and this is a tilde minus a tilde dot a tilde times a tilde dot. This quantity is 0, okay, this quantity equal to 0. Therefore, this gets reduced to 1 minus cos phi, and this is minus minus, then gets plus, and this quantity is 1. So, this is a tilde dot plus sin phi. Okay, so, this is our a tilde cross omega tilde. Okay, same way this a tilde cross times omega tilde, we have already done that. Again, if we operate on this by this one a tilde cross, okay. So, this will be 1 minus cos phi and the whatever the previous result we have got. So, a tilde cross times a tilde dot plus sin phi a tilde cross times a tilde cross times a tilde.
Sir, thoda disturb karo sir. Haan. Isse ek ghanta cross kar gaya sir class.
Haan, to isko usme cut karke three parts mein nahi kar sakte hain.
Haan, wohi wohi main pichle mein aapko disturb ke bich mein bol raha isliye. Haan, haan, wo kar sakte hain.
Haan.
To aap ek kaam kijiye, aap thoda continue kijiye beta.
Haan, isko main continue karta hu.
Is khatam hua hone ko aap log divide part karte hain.
हाँ, और इस लेक्चर को थोड़ा मैं एडिट कर लूँगा, क्योंकि एक दो जगह पर कहीं कहीं पर मैं रुका हूँ.
अच्छा, टाइम तो नोट कर रखा है, जब करेंगे आपको आपके सामने कर देंगे.
अच्छा, ठीक है,
खत्म हो खत्म हो, हम काट देंगे.
हाँ, इसको मैं ख़त्म कर लेता हूँ आज, सोच रहा हूँ पूरा कर लेने को आज. ठीक है. ओके, सो दिस इज द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड, वी हैव मल्टीप्लाइड बाय दिस, तो राइट हैंड साइड ऑल्सो गेट्स मल्टीप्लाइड बाय दिस. नाउ this part we can simplify, and this part can be written as minus sin phi times a tilde dot and plus 1 minus cos phi times a tilde cross times a tilde dot. So, what we have done, that a tilde cross a tilde dot. So, this is nothing but your a cross a dot, we have done earlier the same thing, a cross a dot. This is what we have done earlier also. Now, here this is a cross. Okay. So, okay, we will do it here. So, for this quantity, then this is a dot a minus c times a dot. So, this quantity is 0, because this is the inner product of this, we have already proved this. So, only this part remains, and this equal to 1. So, therefore, this is minus a dot, and therefore, this we can write from this place if we use this here. So, this way our things have got simplified. Now, this is the equation B, which is equal to A tilde cross omega tilde. Now, if we solve A and B for assuming phi dot and A tilde dot, assuming A tilde dot, and these are the two variables involved here, A tilde dot and this one. So, you assume this, if you look here in this one, this is your one variable, this is another variable on the right hand side, and go on the previous one. Here also, if you look, A tilde cross, A tilde times A tilde cross dot, and here A tilde dot. So, in both the places the same thing is appearing. Okay. Okay. So, if we solve it assuming A tilde dot and A tilde cross A tilde dot to be two variables, and remember that this will be equal to minus A tilde dot times A tilde. So, assuming this to be two variables, and if we try to solve it, we will get A tilde dot, because this is one of the variable which what we are looking for. We are not looking for this one, we are looking for this. So, A tilde dot, this gets reduced to 1 by 2 A tilde cross. This is known to us, because this is the vector about which we are giving rotation. This is cot phi by 2 times A tilde cross times A tilde cross and omega tilde. So, from omega tilde, then we are able to retrieve A tilde dot. So, vice versa, we can go either from this direction to this direction, or either from this to that direction. And phi dot, this will turn out to be A tilde transpose times omega tilde. This already we have done. Because omega is known, so if we pre multiply by A transpose, this gets reduced to the phi dot. This previously we have proved it. So, we are not repeating here again in this place. So, this is another important conclusion. So, this can be utilized for reducing the quaternions or either the Euler rates to a compact format, which is very useful. So, we will continue in the next lecture. Thank you.